This is a chromosome, and this is also a chromosome. Why do they look different? Let's talk about the difference between duplicated and unduplicated chromosomes. Hi, biology friends. I'm Sarah, and I'm your other biology professor. And today, we're going to take a look at why and when we have duplicated or replicated chromosomes and unduplicated or unreplicated chromosomes. So what we're not doing today is talking about duplication mutations. I'll definitely do a video on that, but not this one. Remember, a chromosome is a molecule of DNA wrapped up by proteins. Before a cell divides, it has to make sure it has enough genetic content for that one cell to produce two cells that each have the appropriate amount of DNA. So before mitosis and before meiosis I, we're going to have to make copies of all of the DNA in that cell's nucleus. This happens during the S phase, the synthesis phase. The cell is going to use DNA replication in order to copy all of the chromosomes in that cell's nucleus. That's going to generate duplicated chromosomes. A duplicated chromosome consists of two molecules of DNA. They are identical to each other, and they are connected at the centromere. These two parts of the chromosome are called sister chromatids. They each represent one molecule of DNA bound to protein, and if we did it right, they're going to be identical in terms of DNA sequence, length, and shape. So in the picture, I've got a few chromosomes. How many molecules of DNA do you see? And how many chromosomes? We've got three unduplicated chromosomes. Each one of those is going to consist of a single molecule of DNA, so that's three. And we have two duplicated chromosomes with two sister chromatids each. Each of those duplicated chromosomes is going to have two DNA molecules. So here we're looking at a total of five chromosomes, seven molecules of DNA. Let's do a little wrap up. An unduplicated or unreplicated chromosome is one chromosome consisting of one molecule of DNA and proteins. You're going to find unduplicated, unreplicated chromosomes in cells that are not actively dividing or that have just started or are wrapping up the process of cellular division. Replicated or duplicated chromosomes, again, a single chromosome, but these consist of two molecules of DNA and proteins. We've got sister chromatids that are identical to each other and joined at this centromere. You're going to find duplicated DNA in cells that are actively dividing, from the point at which DNA is replicated during the S phase all the way until sister chromatids are pulled apart in anaphase of mitosis or in anaphase II of meiosis. And then you're back to unduplicated chromosomes again. Because they appear and then disappear at set stages in the cell cycle, the presence of duplicated chromosomes is always a really great clue on exam questions as to which stage of the cell cycle you're in. Good luck identifying those chromosomes. Drop me a like if this was helpful. Don't forget to subscribe and check out my website for even more biology content, and I'll see you next time.